Welcome to the Museum of African American Art, where they're presenting the Palmer Hayden Collection, featuring John Henry. I had come just in time for Black History Month, and to my surprise, was able to get an exclusive one-on-one tour with the museum's president, Berlinda Fontenot Jamerson.
Hello and welcome to Regina Knows, and I'm here at the African American Museum in the Major Department, and I'm here speaking with Ms. Berlinda Fontenot Jamerson. She is the spokesperson for the African American Museum, and she's going to discuss the art of the museum.
Okay, well, today we're in the museum, we are the Museum of African American Art, because there is another museum across the way, which is our sister museum, the California African American Museum. There are two different entities, so I just wanted to make that clear. We're in the gallery of the museum, where we are featuring our Palmer Hayden collection, which is a world-renowned collection, and which is, again, what makes us a museum. Museums must have a permanent collection of some sort. That is very technical, but long story short, this is a world-renowned collection from the Harlem Renaissance period. And what we're looking at here now is one piece from the collection called Midsummer Night in Harlem. And this is one of the most famous pieces. It's traveled to England, to Spain, to Italy. Was in the Queen of England's gallery for about 2 months and traveled all down through Europe. We get lots of requests for any and all of these pieces. You might have seen them published in books and magazines, on cards, posters. And so we're very proud to be the repository for this collection.
So you know what's so funny? I actually adore the Harlem Renaissance. I have done a piece of a lengthy piece during the
Harlem
Renaissance. It's one of my favorite periods in time. Can you show us another piece of this?
Sure. Other famous pieces are the John Henry collection. You might have heard as a kid about John Henry.
This is a John Henry collection of series.
This is a renowned collection, and we get quite a bit of interest and activity from across the United States, Tennessee, who have found some artifacts and historical pieces, some letters and some paperwork that suggests that there really was a John Henry. Now, how much of the story and how it was told, I don't know. A few years back, we were contacted by representatives from the Smithsonian, and they wanted to purchase three pieces for $90,000.
Wow.
Well, we had to decline because the stipulation in the Palmer Hayden Trust is that the art never be sold. We are the repository, we are the keepers, and it can travel, and we have to share it with the world, but never to be sold. You know, it's a complicated process that the Palmer Hayden Trust has to be involved in. We have to decline that offer, but ironically, you know, they could have had it for free.
Yeah.
Oh, that, and now they're trying to get free pieces. They don't want to make big money like that.
What a valuable piece of history to know. You know, it's so funny, like I said, Black history is not just 1 month, it's every day.
It is.
And I'm very honored and delighted to be here to be able to speak with you and to look over this fine art, especially from my culture and from the background, and I'm just overwhelmed right now. Is there anything else that you'd like to share?
Yeah, we'll take you through. This museum has been here since 1976. We've been in existence since 1976. We've been in Spain since 1977.
Wow.
And we've been here when Macy's predecessor stores, the Broadway, I don't know, you may be too young to remember the Broadway store. Today we have nearly 9,000 square feet. I'll show you the rest of it, or some of the rest of it. This is the foyer area and the gallery, I'm sorry, the gift shop. We are a nonprofit entity. And that means that we're not here to make money. We're here to just keep the doors open. As you can see, we don't charge to get in. Parking is free. What a deal, right? You can come. And we hope that people find something in our gift shop. About everything you see is for sale. Some of it is from our permanent collection, like the wall hanging. It's a historical piece, that one over there. come from all parts of Africa and South America and America. We feature art of and about African descent people. They don't have to be African American. They can be African descent people. And we define art very broadly. We define art, everything from traditional painting, sculptures, to jewelry, to clothing, music. We define art very broadly. And we try to feature exhibits and shows that represent our history and our culture.
Like the 90s that built LA.
That's right.
No white jeans after Labor Day. What are you, my grandmother? I rock white jeans whenever I want, and with Tide Plus bleach, they'll stay white. Not whitish, not eggshell, not egg crew, whatever that is. White, that's my Tide. What's yours?
Where we're featuring a special exhibition in partnership with the Los Angeles Urban League.
Leadership is the capacity to translate vision into reality, and that's happening at Barr, Floyd, Covington, Wesley Brazar, Blair H. Taylor, also Wesley Brazier. And right here we have John Mack. John Mack is served as the president of the Los Angeles Urban League.
Items that you see, pictures, shoes, hats, trophies, are folks who are representative of people, what they did and how
we
they
did. We even have our very own Bishop Blake.
Yeah, he's my bishop. I just left her.
Me too.
Maybe that's where I came. You look for me.
Yeah. That's wonderful. Mm-hmm. When I first came and seen this, back in December, I couldn't help myself. I was just overjoyed. I was speechless. I said to myself, this is really my community. Ms. Jameson, what is your favorite piece here?
You know, I don't have a favorite piece. I mean, each one of them affect me in different ways. You know, I like the whole collage. And I like the diversity of pieces that we have here. And I really don't have a favorite piece. I like, you know, I can find something in each one of them that I'm looking at. And maybe because of my long time. I'm not an artist.
Dalkin News.
Of course, we all know about the
Soul Train. And right over here is the award monster. This is Tom and Ethel Bradley, Ethel Bradley and Tom. He was elected mayor in this seat. Emma was Ms. Bradley with a hat. He served 5 terms for mayor of Los Angeles. And this is the Sweet Alice. Alice Harris is a community activist and director of Parents of Watch, Courses, Health, and Career.
Iconic Addie McDowell, she was the first African American to receive an Academy Award for Best Supporting Actress in Gone with the Wind. Patty actually wore a tulip in her hair, in which Monique wore when she won for Best Supporting Actress in Precious. This piece represents the burning and rebuilding of the Los Angeles riots with Rodney King. All 4 employees in the quick. Yeah, it was a really, really horrendous time. But we made it through, as we all can see.
Well, my question is to let people know where the museum is at and how to get in contact with you. They want to come and purchase art or any jewelry or to know who you are.
Well, the Museum of African American Art is located inside of Mason's Ballin Hills. We're at 4005 Crenshaw Boulevard. And we want to be real clear that people know we are on the 3rd floor of Mason's. Because people will say, I heard it was there, but I can't be inside of Macy's. That can't be right, but yes, it is right. It's correct. We are on the third floor of Macy's.
Well, I want to personally thank you for your service here for this amazing, inspiring historical museum. And I'm floored to be here to talk to you. I'm honored. Thank you so much.
Come back.
I will.